The strongest evidence we have that elephants understand anything at all comes from a series of experiments at the Detroit Zoo. First, elephants were presented singly with a tube in which a morsel of food was inserted. Both elephants retrieved the food immediately by either sucking or blowing. They showed no preference for either sucking or blowing. When immediately after they could only obtain a treat from a tube by suction, they almost immediately switched to suction, suggesting that they understood the nature of the situation without resorting to trial and error, or that they, unknown to us, played such games before. We then created a situation where only blowing yielded a delectable morsel, immediately followed by a situation where only suction would yield that morsel. Again, the switch from one to the other was instant.
It's a game. It's a game. They like to play.
Like, I mean, you get it so that you have blown an A right now. No, wouldn't that be
good? Good girl. Only blowing.
You gotta learn to play it right. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for count when the dealing's done.
Winky got it?
Now
good,
every
Winky.
Gambler knows.
Get it, Winky.
The secret to survive.
Oh, get it. Wanda got it now. Nobody is blowing.
We first interpreted this remarkable performance as evidence of thinking, of working out things in their minds without the benefit of trial and error. But subsequent experiments in the jungle placed this interpretation in doubt. Two Burmese elephants were unable to retrieve food from a tube by either sucking or blowing, raising the possibility that Wanda and Winky had been trained to suck and blow before we had set eyes on them. This negative conclusion is supported by the following competitive situation, where the two elephants do not seem to grasp what's going on.
Oh,
the huge drone! He touched the drone.
No, they
didn't.
You know it,
but
if you touch the
drone. Okay, Wanda
is giving it to Winky. No! That's not how it goes. The hold up. Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough to count when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table.
Well, that's what I say.
Eventually, they will learn, but right now, it seems they don't get it. followed the ingenious experimental protocol of Daniel Povinelli and his colleagues. We conducted our experiments with some 16 elephants and introduced a few modifications to the original design. To begin with, and following numerous trials of begging from a person holding a bucket, when given a choice between a large object and a human being, elephants always beg from the human being. Likewise, after lifting a lid off a bucket to get food hundreds of times, if given a choice between a lid and a person, the elephant always begs from the person. Elephants almost always prefer a man to a scarecrow. They prefer a man who is covered from the waist down to a man who is covered from the waist up. They prefer a man facing them to a man who has his back turned to them. In other instances, where the differences between the two men is not as sharp, the performance of 16 elephants in three different locations averaged 69%, 19% higher than controls, and 18% higher than chance. These results are not as clearly behavioristic as Povinelli's and, depending perhaps on one's ideology, can be interpreted as either supporting or refuting Povinelli's pessimistic view of animal mentality. For our part, we tentatively accept Povinelli's conclusion, even though our elephants and our chimpanzees performed much better than his chimpanzees, 54%. Our rationale for this is simple. One can easily ascribe 70% correct choices to trial and error learning, but one is hard put explaining why an elephant who understands that people see fails to act on that knowledge in 30% of the cases. Anyway, here are a few fragments of the actual experiments. First, we had to teach them how to beg, which in most cases involves a simple reinforcement of an already existing habit.